What's happened, Dr. Silvert?
Dimitri's responding. The treatment's successful, isn't it?
Well, I can tell you that the treatment's had some effect. Mr. Merrick is no longer comatose.
My God.
Is he oriented?
Oh, yes. He's asking for you.
How are you feeling?
Feeling.
Hungry?
For the sight of you. You know how much I love you.
Yeah, I know.
We'll always love you.
I'll always love you.
Don't want you to suffer.
I'm not suffering.
It's not fair.
It's a miracle, is what it is.
No.
I gotta tell you, brother, first time I saw you, it was kind of scary, but now, she's a genius, your wife.
My wife.
Yeah. You look so much better.
We still have a ways to go.
Fine, fine, whatever. Just welcome back.
Alex, I need to talk to Edmund alone.
Just left.
You take care of him, Alex?
I think I have enough on my plate taking care of you, thank you very much.
He's been sad man long time.
I know.
You so lovely.
No. I haven't slept in a week.
Well, don't contradict a sick man.
Okay. No, sir.
So lovely. You tell me about the stream.
Oh, where I used to go with my father.
Yeah.
Again. Well, it was most beautiful in the springtime when there were daffodils everywhere, masses of them all over the banks. They were so beautiful. Father really loved them. And the little blue ones. I forget what they're called, the tiny ones. They grow right down by the water's edge. And sometimes I find a frog. And I'd slip him in my pocket and take him home to scare Mom. And there'd be soft stones that I'd dip in the water. And I'd watch them change color. And the fish would poke their